Hi there! Today we're going to be talking about economies of scope. An economy of scope is, it sounds like economy of scale, but it's actually quite a bit different. So an economy of scope happens essentially and more often when a company produces multiple products as opposed to one product or a specific industry. So more or less, as a company develops itself into a multi-product company, we can calculate its PPF or its product possibility frontier. And essentially what this is that they are able to increase the average production of products while also reducing the average price per unit. Now, we can calculate this in a few different ways. So as you see here, we have PPF 1, 2, and 3. Here along the blue curve, well not curve, but the blue line, we seem to have a fixed price. This company will not do very well with economy of scope. It may already be a company in which produces multiple products or various types of units, but the price will not fluctuate. This curved unit here, this curved green line, is going to be an economy of scope company, which is benefiting from multi-products. And as you can see, the dot that moves along this means that the production of the values on the X and the Y, you might be able to produce more Y, but you would have to produce less X for the same average cost production. Now, when it comes to these organizations that are producing multiple products, more or less, it's more about the shared infrastructure between these production lines and the shared expertise. There are some other factors that can also contribute to this, but imagine you're working in a company that produces two different types of soap. Well, the people that made the first type of soap already have expertise of the machines for the plastic production, and there's also another team for the soap production, or the soap mixing, or whatever, however they make their soap, whatever they're doing over there. So they share their expertise with the team from the new department for the new soap, and that shared expertise actually helps reduce costs in training because overall the company is growing. Now, when it comes to the products themselves sharing the same infrastructure, if you don't have to develop a new factory, you don't have to create a new facility, you only need to buy a new, maybe, plastic pressing or printing unit. Well, in this case, you don't need to spend that much more money. You don't need a new building, you don't need more infrastructure, etc. Coming back to our PPF, or production possibility frontier, we can see that our line here is linear and fixed. Now, a economy of scope, for example, we have a 7 and a 6 units of production here. Now, definitely check this out in your books or online when you get the chance, production possibility frontier, or PPF. It's a very good equation and a very good system. Now, if we produce 4 units of Y, we can only produce 4 units of X in an economy not of scope. The opposite can also be true about an economy of scope. Well, not necessarily an economy of scope, but a company that has multi-products or is a multi-product company. It's called a diseconomy of scope, where when you produce 4 units of X, you can only produce 1 unit of Y for the same average cost balance, essentially. The average reduction of cost for an economy of scope company is felt by the consumer and also helps the company out quite a bit too. A common economy of scope could be a supermarket, Amazon, Walmart, or a myriad of other different companies. Dove is also a good example of this. How many different soaps and products they have actually costs you less money for more products because of the way that they do it. However, in the end run, it is possible for the complexity to cause more difficulties and problems, resulting in an increased average price per unit. Now, that's all I've got for you today, but thank you for tuning in. If you liked that, or even if you hated it, please like, share, subscribe, and hit that little bell button, and we'll see you next time.